Okay, so I gotta figure out some things on my budget, and best thing to do that is post it on YouTube so I remember when I go back to it. This is more or less for me, so I understand what's happening with my collection and thrifting. I'm getting lack of sleep now, so I have to wake up early to go thrifting. And I'll probably sleep when I get back. I don't know if all the thrift stores will open up today. If that does, then I'll probably just go to two of them. Then later on, if it's warm, I can go to the other two. And I'm going to try to pick up some board games if I can, because there's still at least two board games I want to get. And I know on eBay they cost at least $100. And I'm trying not to buy anything online this summer, winter. So I think whatever I have on the way, that's it. Probably till next year. I think when I get my tax refund, I'm gonna keep it for locally. I break things down further, depends on the pop. If the pop right now, it's killing my budget. So I'm paying almost $80 on pop if I'm buying Coke, like Pepsi, Sprite, ginger ale. Those pops, I think, forget about them. And but I can at least buy one box every month. I get rid of the pop. But I've been trying to get around that, but I don't like coffee and tea. I tried a couple different teas, but they're all pretty crap. And I try to put sugar into it, it still tastes like water. I haven't found a tea that I like that could really change the flavor to my taste. So I don't know, tea. I might try tea again at some point. Kool-Aid. I cannot find Kool-Aid anywhere. They have the little liquid mixes, but that does not change the taste of the water. It just changes the color. And that's not going to be good for me. The only other, I try like iced tea. It's kind of iffy. Iced tea powder. I'm trying other powders to try to balance out the cost of Coke. If I could do that, then I could start buying some more stuff for my collection. That'll take out at least $70 on pop and junk food, so I could reduce junk food a little bit. But I still need some pop. I still need pop. I could probably get $1 pop. I need pop, I could get $1 pop. That's the only best thing I could do for my budget right now, and hopefully thrifting will open up. All of them will open up at the same time, I don't know, but I'll try to go to at least one or two. And if Goodwill is open, I don't know, then I'll go to Goodwill. The other store brands might open up, but there could be a long way to get in. I have to go there early. So that's why I'm probably running on low sleep. I don't really feel tired right now, but later on I will be, because I have to adjust my sleep to the morning. So pretty much what's happening right now. And if you're in a tight budget where you have payments or school payments, good luck with that. And best thing to do is get out of it as soon as you can. Going to school, you can get a pile of shit up your ass and never get out of the debt, and just keeps adding and adding, and schools love it because they get the money that way out of you. So be careful with full-time stuff, full-time programs. And things aren't looking as bad. I've still got some snacks to go through, so I'm just deciding what I should buy
extra for chips. I could at least get one or two chocolates. These do me pretty good, and I love these cookies better than Oreo, so I'll probably get these ones again. Crackers, maybe I might do with the crackers or chips, so. Still got a couple of things here I could go through. And that's my favorite wine. So I don't have any more wine after this one. That's done. So I have it in the budget to buy some wine. But some boxes I need to finish up. Like Smallville. I need, I think, one more for Smallville. I'm going to keep an eye out for that. Last thing I completed was Friends. And I completed MacGyver quite a while ago. So I did all right on that. And I'll do a review of MacGyver. I think I already did a review of Friends. So, that's how they look like. And I want to try to complete Stargate this summer. And Stargate Atlantis. I think I have some right here. I only have two of them. But that's if I plan my budget carefully and if I try to reduce my pop cost. So I tried different powders. Let me know how you're doing on your budget, how you're dealing with the cost of pop. I know a lot of you drink coffee to substitute, but I'm not a coffee drinker, but I might have to, I don't know. I never buy coffee when I go to the coffee shops. I always just buy a sandwich, and that's my lunch, or a juice or something. I'll buy you something after. I never buy a coffee in a coffee shop, so I don't really like the taste that much. Especially homemade. So sometimes I could handle the coffee in the coffee shops. See, they make different flavors, but I don't know, I tried a lot of juice mixes. And a lot of them are really watery and don't do nothing. There's still a couple other juice mixes I could try if I could find Kool-Aid. I'm not paying the Kool-Aid price online. It's like $40 for a tub, and that's just way too much. I don't like the Kool-Aid liquid they have. And yeah, I think the small juice boxes are too expensive. If I could get away from that stuff this summer, then that'll be good. So I know the juice boxes too, they're very expensive, so. Thanks for watching, hope you're sticking with your budget and get some good stuff added to my collection this summer. Get sort of a vlog update on the budget and how things are going. Keep in there if you have a debt to pay, and it's really tough. I'm not getting anything ahead this summer, so I'm just like right on the button, going day by day.